Good morning. Today we will discuss about the radiology of primary CNS lymphoma. It happens mostly immunocompromised patients and some patients with though even they are in immunocompetent. So if you see the lesion characteristics in the CT or MR, it is a mostly small to big, usually single, maybe multiple edema. There is a small edema, mass effect will be there. Enhancement pattern, mostly homogeneous enhancement, the solid component. You may find thick enhancing wall. There is no necrosis. Both component you will find cystic and solid. Calcification hemorrhages are rare. So if you see the imaging characteristics, CT is a hyper intense. T1 into hyper 2 iso intense. T1 contrast typically high grade tumors with intense homogeneous enhancement, while low grade tumors have absent to moderate enhancement. Peripheral ring enhancement may be seen in immunocompromised patients. And T2 MR is hypo to iso. Flare. In the flare image, it will be hyper intense R100 by hyosinine hemicema. If you differentiate from the MRS, it is a mostly large colon peak, reversed colon creatinine ratio, marked decrease of NA. And a lactate peak may be seen. In perfusion scan, if you see, there will be only modest. If it is increased, it is but not more than that of the high grade gliomas, because here high grade gliomas is new angiogenesis is a prominent feature. There is a lots of diffusion because of lots of diffusion restriction due to diffusion restriction because of hypercellularity, and correspondingly in edema map you will see in the dark or low. Radiology, it was usually multiple, deeply located, corpus callosum involvement, floppy appearance, periventricular location, enhancing, submendymal seedling, and relatively low vasogenic edema, but no central necrosis. So in this finding, if you see, this is MR finding, is in a T1 weighted, it is a hypo to iso intense. In T2 weighted hyper intense, in flare, you can see the edema here. In diffusion weighted image, it looks hyper, and so there is a lots of restriction here. In EDIS, corresponding EDIS map, the area looks black. And post contrast enhancement, there is a homogeneous, brilliantly enhancing. If you see the appearance, it's like a sky pattern. You can see there is a corpus callosum and looks like a cotton ball or fluffy appearance. You can see this and compare with this fluffy appearance. Usually multiple, it happens also single, but it happens also multiple lesions here and there. And if you see, mostly looks like it is in the periventricular location. It is mostly, it is a quite a differentiating picture from other problems. It is mostly the periventricular location. Corpus callosum involvement is a common, it is one of the prominent features on the CNS lymphoma, a primary CNS lymphoma. You can see here corpus callosum involvement. Sometimes butterfly gliomas happens in the brainstem gliomas, but there is a solid brainstem glioblastomas. Corpus callosum involvement more in CNS, primary CNS lymphomas, and it happens in the glioblastoma, not brainstem glioma. It happens in the glioblastoma. So usually glioblastoma or gliomas, we can call it a butterfly gliomas, but there may be solid cystic component, and you can see here homogeneous enhancement we will not find in the gliomas. You can see here classic butterfly gliomas. Here is the glioblastoma and here is the lymphoma. In glioblastoma, you can see the peripherals enhancing with central necrosis, but here homogeneous enhancement. You can see here homogeneous enhancement and in floppy, and looks like floppy appearance. Here in glioblastoma, it looks like central necrosis and peripheral ring enhancement. See, this is the classic butterfly lesion. If you are getting butterfly lesions, any radiological finding, you can think of two lesions. One is the glioblastoma or some gliomas or high grade gliomas, or CNS lymphoma. CNS lymphoma, homogeneous enhancement, gliomas, ring enhancement, and central necrosis. Another picture, you can see the diffusion weighted image here. If you see the diffusion weighted image, there is a, because of the lymphoma hypercellularity, there is a restriction. Restriction means you will see the hyper intense area in the lesion in the diffusion weighted image. Correspondingly, if you see the ADC map, you can measure here, there is a low ADC value and dark in appearance. Remember, more the good ADC value, and that is good, and low ADC value is more malignant, and it is also helpful for the prognosis, response prognosis. It is a response assessment after giving chemotherapy. We can differentiate whether good response or less response. Perfusion scan, if you see low perfusion, or even if some slightly perfused, it is not more than the high grade glioma. You can see here that enhancing lesion, it is a blood flow is less. If you see the MRS picture, colon create poder, you will definitely you will be colon peak, and if you are lucky enough, you will get a lipid peak. So this is the lipid peak and colon peak and lipid peak. Sometimes you will get orbital involvement. 80% of orbital lymphomas have a concomitant intracerebral mass, but 10% intraparenchymal CNS have a orbital lymphoma. So it is not very common. 10% have a intraorbital involvement. How to differentiate GBM versus peripheral CNS, a primary CNS lymphoma? GBM, solid cystic component. Here is solid component. And high perfusion, low perfusion, you can see it easily differentiate in GBM versus peripheral. And GBM is a single lesion. Peripheral CNS lymphoma, most of the times, is a multiple and a periventricular location. Metastasis versus primary CNS lymphoma, how to differentiate? Metastasis, usually multiple. Even CNS lymphomas, primary CNS lymphomas are having also multiple lesions. But how to differentiate? Mostly the lymphomas located in the periventricular, deep in the gray matter. But in CNS metastasis, usually mostly the gray-white junction. So this is the primary versus secondary lymphomas. How to differentiate? Most of the primary CNS lymphomas having the parenchymal involvement. But in the secondary CNS, when there is another lymphoma is there and spread to the brain, most of the, there is a leptomeningeal involvement and ependymal sibling. If you see this black highlighted area, in primary, it is mostly parenchymal lesion. In brain, in a CNS secondary CNS lymphoma, it is a leptomeningeal involvement. So if the when it is comes with multiple lesions, we have to differentiate from the metastasis. If there is a single lesion, looks like high grade, you have to differentiate by GBM. So I have explained about these things, how to differentiate the brain secondaries, how to differentiate by the GBM. I have explained about the diffusion weighted image. I have explained about the perfusion. Thank you very much.